Welcome to the third installment of the Teach Me CQL series. This series is presented by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. It is intended to support healthcare quality leaders, health IT vendors, and measure developers explore the use of clinical quality language, or CQL. In today's segment, we will discuss the use of several functions contained in the Global Common Library, Latest, LatestOf, Earliest, EarliestOf, HasStart, and HasEnd. As we've done in previous sessions, we will use current eCQM logic examples to illustrate the lesson. You may recall from our first session that the Global Common Library, or GCL, is a shared library that contains agreed-upon definitions and functions that are maintained by eCQM developers and used in eCQM program measures from year to year. This shared library allows measure developers to more easily reference frequently used chunks of CQL logic across eCQMs. This benefits measure developers and implementers, since it promotes the use of the same chunks of logic across eCQMs and decreases variation in eCQM specifications. With the specifications for 2023 reporting, the GCL was published on the eCQI Resource Center as a standalone document. Now that we have reminded ourselves about the GCL, let's take a look at some specific content. Today, we will be using CMS 165, Controlling High Blood Pressure, version 11, for our example. The numerator for this measure is looking for patients whose most recent blood pressure is adequately controlled during the measurement period. I emphasize the term most recent because that is where we will see the use of the LatestOf function. Here we see the numerator logic and contents of the definitions that make up the numerator statement. We will focus on the diastolic blood pressure definitions for today to keep things simple. We see here in the lowest diastolic reading definition the use of the LatestOf function from the Global Common Library. We know it's from that library because of the word global before the LatestOf name. We can see that the LatestOf function is looking for the latest diastolic blood pressure that occurred on the same day as the most recent blood pressure. How does this function work? As we can see in the function section of the eCQM, each specific function used in the logic is pulled in from the Global Common Library and included in the eCQM. First, we note the latest function is actually used within the LatestOf function. As we read through the latest function, we learn this function will take an interval and return the end of that interval. If there is not an end to the interval, then it will return the starting point. We can then look at the LatestOf function and walk through how it works. As we look at the LatestOf function, we see that it uses latest, normalized interval, and HasEnd functions. As you recall from previous sessions, the normalized interval function simplifies logic, looking at clinical data elements like labs or assessments that may have either a date, time, or an interval associated with it. So the LatestOf function will take in the date, time, or period associated with the data element, in our current example, the diastolic blood pressure reading, and normalize it, and then use the latest function to find the endpoint. It uses the HasEnd function to test if the interval being used in the latest function has an end date time. If the interval does not have an end date time, the HasEnd function will return false, and then the latest logic will go on to the next line and look for the end of the interval. While we don't have a measure example that uses the LatestOf function in the Global Common Library, it seems like a good time to review this now. We can take what we learned about the LatestOf function and simply look to the start of the intervals. So the LatestOf function will take in the date time or period associated with the data element, normalize it, and then use the earliest function to find the start point. It uses the HasStart function to test if the interval being used in the earliest function has a start date time. If the interval does not have a start date time, the HasStart function will return false, and then the earliest logic will go on to the next line and look for the start of the interval. You now have a better understanding of several functions from the Global Common Library. Come back for our next installment, where we will review the CQL function, coalesce.